Welcome to Pokhara Lake, Nepal. It's Saturday afternoon. It's a really nice day here today. As soon as I turn the camera on, everybody starts staring at me. I sat here, but I've been sitting here for at least 15 minutes without putting the camera on. But now that I'm talking to the camera, everybody's like, look at that guy. I'll give you a view of those guys. So this big swing here appeared about 7 or 8 days ago during the Dashin festive time, which ended just a couple days ago. And one of the traditions of that is the adults build swings for all the young children that want to play on a swing. It's kind of a traditional thing. This swing is just a basic rope swing hanging up here. But over here, you'll see the bamboo swing. You probably can't distinguish it. Maybe I'll walk over and show it later. This is Fueta Lake in Pokhara. So today is Saturday, the first Saturday after the big week of festivals. And it's still another week before the second big festival season, which is Tihar. And this, as some of you may know, is the festival about 6 or 7 days where the first 4 days, they honor a different subject for the whole day. The first day being crows. They honor the crow because they carry the sorrow of Hinduism. And I only know that because I read it this yesterday. But the second day is the day of... The second day is the day of the cows. Cows before that. The second day is the day of the cow, for Mother Cow, the giver of life for India and this region. And we are actually in Nepal. But I'm speaking more of Hindustan, which Nepal would be considered part of Hindustan. So the second day is honoring cows. Cows are given a garland of marigolds, a tikka on the forehead, and fed good grasses all day and treats. And also given a bath. People will wash all the cows. There is no more sacred cows, no cows wandering in Kathmandu. And that's been for many, many years. But cows still wander here, and actually they wander right through here. I won't be surprised if we don't see a cow in the next 10 or 15 minutes. Could possibly happen. The next day, though, after that, is the day for the dog. Man's most faithful companion, as it was stated in the Hindu references that I was reading. That is the reason why they honor the dog, because they are faithful companions. And they are given a tikka on the forehead in red, and a garland also. I haven't seen a lot of street dogs that I would consider really wild dogs on my trip this time to Pokhara. My little street that I live on is right here. And I'm in, you might be able to read the Lotus, Hotel Lotus. That's my hotel that I'm in. This little street here goes up really about 10, 15 blocks. I only wander about 2 blocks of it. And there's hotels and 2 or 3 restaurants that I really like. But there's a few pet dogs along the way there. And a pet dog is usually somebody's animal that they keep, but they don't typically keep that close a track on the dog. He's allowed to wander up and down the street as he wishes, comes home when he wants, and gets fed. And treated very well. Now there are people that have lap dogs now, the little dogs that are always at their side, you know, the little, there's actually Chihuahuas here. I've seen Chihuahuas, but they're not that popular. The Pug is the really popular dog here, the one that I see people honor the most. And then there are street dogs that are just pretty mangy, but they're usually treated really, really well. They're not treated terribly at all. Much better than any other place I've ever been. Dogs are treated well because I've heard once it was explained to me that dogs, being the faithful companion of humans,